Happy morning, dear children. Valha valamudan. Yes, what do you understand about the picture which is on your screen? Yes, the people raise their hands for what? For their rights. Are they not feel something comfortable for them? So for that, against they raise their hands. Okay. Yes, dear, this chapter, what is that key elements of democratic government? Okay. Yes, that is the chapter for us. Already we saw in the first unit what is called diversity and what is called government. Why do we need a government? Everything. And today, the last previous six sessions, we discussed about the democratic government's elements. Okay, democratic government means it is not only that head of the state or country elected by the people, but the people also participate in the decision making. Okay, not only the representative as the decision make authority. If their decision is not good, if their decision is not comfortable for the people, so we should raise our voice and raise our hands against their decision. Okay, already we saw the people's democracy and role of the people in the decision making and how they should participate in the public procession and protest everything. Okay, how the people also following. Today, conflicts and conflict solution. What is called conflicts? Yes, children, small problems, issues, okay, inconvenience, these are called conflicts. Okay, so the government as well as the people wants to search the solutions. Okay, search the ways for the solution. For example, two houses are there. Because of some reason, for example, they are boundaries, they are a compound wall or some other problems, they making, there is some conflicts among themselves. Who will solve this? Like this, we have in the state-wise, country-wise, everywhere. Okay, so here conflicts arise not only among two neighbors, it can arise religion, region, between two countries, caste and so many cultures, economic divide. Okay, so how we bring the solution for conflicts? What is called conflicts, Kane? Conflicts means problems and issues. Okay, yes. In what ways we can bring the solutions? Yes, we already saw that whose Maya's story. Okay, in that a boy shot by the police, assassinated, isn't it? Like that, sometimes it may be the protest or the people's participations given a problems. Okay, for example, in our state, Thoothukudi Sterlite, do you know that company? It's a chemical producing company. So the people in Thoothukudi, they are against the industry. Okay, the people asked to close that industry because they spoil the underground water. The underground water turn into poison chemical, and also the air pollution. That industry make much air pollution. For that, people started a huge protest. Went lakhs and lakhs people in front of the industry to show they are against. Okay, that time the police and army started to shoot. That time 13 members killed in that protest. Okay, so this may given sometimes like this happened. Okay, so that also conflicts. Okay, in what way we bring the solutions? Okay, in Maya stories, we read about the boy how shot by the police and death occur. Okay, because one group decides that it is all right to use forced to prevent the other group from protesting. Okay, here the government decided to keep the Sterlite company industry there itself. So the government given a order to the police to shoot the protesters, the people. Okay, so the one authority decided to keep the things there. Okay, that conflicts occur when people or different countries. In where the conflicts occur, it occurs not only in one country, it may be between two countries, religions, cultures and economic divide. Okay, because of what reason that conflicts arise? Lack of tolerance and respect between communities also result in conflict. Okay, here they are giving between two communities. Okay, when one community people think that they are superior, or they are thinking the other community peoples are inferior for them, inferior than them, that means that really or surely there is a conflicts will arise. Okay, so lack of tolerance among between two religion or between two communities, anything, is the result conflict. Okay, then for example, I heard that people in your Kanyakumari, they are not allowed the rally at the time of religious rally at the time of Vinayagar Chaturthi, because that area fully the people of Christians lived in that area. So they are not allowed the Vinayagar's rally in that area. And I also heard in one places in Coimbatore, there is a place the Hindu people will not allow the Muslim people to enter or to do their work in particular area. So this is shows they are irrespect. Okay, they are not respect the other religion. Okay, so it is not good. It is not correct. All the religions are equal only. Okay, so we should respect other religion, other communities, whatever it may. So if that tolerance, lack of tolerance, tolerance means we should adjust, we should accept how we are thinking, my religion is best, the same like for them, their religions also best. Okay, so we should not think minds are superior than them, it's not. Then groups that feel discriminated may relative using violent means. And sometimes the groups, if we discriminate anybody or we discriminated by anybody means, that time may retaliate using violent. Okay, in what are the ways conflicts arising? Then competition over scarce resources. People use violent means to settle their differences. And what way they are saying? These ideas leads to fear and tensions among others living in an area. People may use violent. It may give fear to the other people, those who are living in the same area. The government is responsible for helping to resolve conflicts. Okay, children, do you understand? Yes. Now let's read about some of the conflicts in our society and the role of the government in resolving them. Okay. Conflicts can often lead to violence and death because one group decides that it is all right to use force to prevent the other group from protesting. That I told. Good example is Tuticorin Sterlite industry protest. Okay, because the government don't want the people protest against the industry. Okay, children, do you understand? And at the time of Jallikattu protest, that time also the government not allowed to protest the people, and so like that is lot of conflicts arising often. This leads to fear and tension among others living in an area. The government is responsible for helping to resolve conflicts. Okay, yes. tensions that already I told, religious. Some religious are not accept the other religious are equal. They think their religious are superior than the others. That's why the conflicts are the, there is a chance for arising the conflicts. Okay. Yes, children, religious procession and celebration can sometimes lead to conflicts. For example, a route a procession takes may lead to a conflict. Okay. That is, in a particular place, they are not allowed another particular religious procession or rally. Okay. So that is, that time there is a chance to arise the conflict. Okay. So the government, particularly the police, at that time what they are doing? For example, I said in Kanyakumari, a place, that area majority lived by the people, majority by the people of Christians. Okay. So they are not like to allow the Vinayagar's statue through their street, but Hindu people, that is the way to connect to the another street. Okay. Do you understand what I'm saying? That is the main way to connect the another street. That street covered with Hindu people. So what these people will do? That people say, here Vinayagar statues, no need to enter, because that street fully covered, fully lived by the people of Christian. So what we can do this time? So this time the government, particularly the police department, call both religious leaders. For example, who is the big person, important person in that area? Example, that Christian people, maybe as church father, and that Hindu, any priest, anybody's, the police call, and they are ready to compromise in both sides. One, they get permission from the Christian people to allow the Vinayagar's processions to that street, or they are compromised the Hindu priest. They don't want, okay, we will select some other places to enter the another street. In this way, the police brings the solution for the particular conflict. Okay, do you understand, children, what I'm saying? In what way the police bring the solution for this type of, that is religious type of conflicts, means they call both religious leaders. Okay, otherwise the same time, if any areas means, it is not religious means, community wise, caste wise means, they are calling the important people and they are bring the solutions among themselves. The government, particularly the people, play an important role in getting representatives of concerned communities to meet and try and arrive at a solution. Okay. Yes, children, do you understand what I told? In what way they are bringing the solutions? They are speaking both parties. Okay, caste means that caste, important persons or religions or communities, whatever. Okay, in this way they bring the solutions for the communal tensions. Okay, at times there is a fear that violence may erupt. Okay, probably the police can think the that processions or rallies bring a huge violence things happen, with people throwing stones or trying to disrupt the procession. The police are responsible for ensuring that violence does not take place. Okay, children. Yes, reverse too, that we will see in the upcoming 15 minutes. Okay, children, please, you wait for the next 15 minutes. Okay.